Hello everyone and welcome to this week's beauty video. You know, makeup can be expensive, and I mean really, really expensive. Today I thought I'd challenge myself to create a makeup look using my higher-end beauty products together in one look. Now I am a little bit limited by color and shade selection because a lot of these were products sent to me by PR, but we'll see what we come up with. To add a little extra fun, I challenge you to test your beauty knowledge by tallying up all the prices of the beauty products. Don't look it up, no cheating, write down your total in the comments below and check with my actual total at the end of the video. Are you ready? Let's go! Now, I think everyone decides to their own routine where they want to spend the most amount of money in their beauty products, be it in skincare or on makeup or a particular category of makeup products. For me, I think foundations are where I put my money most, just because you have better shade selection, generally speaking. A lot of drugstore foundations are just so awfully pink, especially in the lighter color spectrum. Or if you are on the other end and you have a darker skin tone, they just don't have colors fit for you, unfortunately. For some other people, it might be something like primers or even eyeshadow. I think that tends to be another category that drugstores are really lacking. However, for things like mascara or even brow pencils, you can get away with a lot of really inexpensive and great items from the drugstore. So what really makes a makeup item high-end or high-end priced? Is it the formulation? Is it the color selection? Is it the particular labs that they're being made at? Maybe it's made and milled in Italy versus made and milled in China. I think there's a lot of discrepancy and people have different standards about makeup. A lot of very inexpensive eyeshadows, for example, contain things like mineral oil, which make them feel smoother and apply better, but whether or not you like mineral oil in your makeup products or if they make you break out or not really depends on the individual. I find that after trying out a lot of different priced makeup products, formula and texture are the two things that stand out most. And of course, in addition to a branding or if you know they have a long history of making luxury products, that all goes into the particular pricing as well. For example, the Shu eyeshadows I'm using right here, they may not appear to you on first try as being the most pigmented, the most one swipe does it all shadows, but they layer so beautifully and they're a really great product just for building up intensity and has a wonderful translucency to it. On the other hand, eyebrows, I am still working on my eyebrow game and I could do with a higher end or a lower end product. It doesn't really make a big difference. For some of you out there, I know eyeliner is a big deal as well. You may find that drugstore eyeliners just smudge a lot and they're not as smudge proof, oil proof, and waterproof as certain other high end options. Now, Touche Eclat YSL. This is the first time I'm using it in this video and I gotta say I kind of like it. I've got to use it a bit more though in order to have a final decision on it, but it blends really nicely and maybe sometimes there is a little magic to certain high-end beauty products. I did try to spread out my selection of high-end products for today's video because if I were to use all of my most expensive makeup products, then we would really be just using one or two brands and that wouldn't be a lot of fun now, would it? If you are playing along though and you are guessing the price points of these products, remember that I do live in Canada, so all my pricing at the end will be in Canadian dollars and it might surprise you how truly expensive some of these products really, really are. So I'm curious to know, what is your most expensive beauty product, be it a skincare or a makeup item? What do you swear by that is high end but you absolutely just love? I want to hear about it, so leave me a comment down below and let me know, and you know, don't keep all the secrets to yourself. As we're getting down to the last parts of this makeup look, you'll realize that this is bit of a bolder, more dramatic look than what I'm used to wearing and sharing here on YouTube, mostly because I've been really trying to challenge myself to do something different, to be a bit more creative with my makeup looks. This is not something I would wear on the regular, but I think it's just interesting and creative to expand my horizon, so to speak. So, have you been doing your math? What do you guess is the price of this face? And do you have it right? If you are wanting to see the other spectrum, my cheapest and most affordable makeup face, leave me a comment down below, let me know, and give this video a thumbs up so I know that you loved it. All right, until next time, I'll see you very soon. Take care. Bye.